Hi everyone, welcome to GyanIS Geography. Today we are going to learn about cyclones, specifically tropical cyclones. Tropical cyclones falls in the climatology the broader topic of climatology in your UPSC syllabus. Now geography is very important for your UPSC prelims and mains. Climatology especially is important for your preliminary and mains exam. The cyclones are specifically given in your mains exam syllabus. And if you look at the previous year questions, it is clear that they have asked questions from this area. It's so you need to be prepared very well to answer this question. You need to understand the structure, the formation, its origin to be able to answer all the questions coming from this area. Now, we have seen, one important thing that you have to remember is that I'll be sticking as much as possible to the syllabus and previous year questions. There will not be anything extra in this video. It will be purely based on your previous year questions and the syllabus. Because UPSC has a very vast syllabus. So you have to be very precise in which subjects, what part you have to study. That's where we come in. That's where we can help. We can tell you exactly which portions you have to study and which portions you can afford to skip. Because if you go deeper into any subject, you will not find adequate time to finish the topics of UPSC in time and revise and write a good exam. So we have to be precise. So everything in this video is all essential for your preparation. So let's start with cyclone. We have seen earlier the cyclones are divided into two, basically. The one is tropical cyclone, the other one is extratropical cyclones or temperate cyclones. As the name suggests, tropical cyclones are cyclonic systems which originate in the tropical region of the world. This is a region that lies, suppose this is the equator, this is the region that lies between 30 degree north and 30 degree south. Region lying between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn is a tropical region, and cyclonic storm originating in this region is classified as tropical cyclones. Let's start with the names of tropical cyclones. There are different names given in tropical cyclones. They are known as hurricanes, typhoons, willy willies. You're clear your doubt here. Remember that these are all names of the same phenomena. Only difference is that the place of its origin. The place of its origin varies. For example, in Indian Ocean, a cyclonic depression is known as simply a cyclone. And in Atlantic, it is known as hurricanes. In Pacific, West Pacific and South China Sea, those parts, they are known as typhoons. And in parts of Australia, they are known as willy willies. So remember, these are the same phenomena. These are the names of the same phenomena. They are known by different names in different parts of the world. The structure, their origin, and roughly their area. They occupy this tropical region. So all are the same. But this could be a potential question for your exam. They could jumble up this. They could mix it up and ask you to identify the correct answer from the options given. So take note, this is important. The names and the corresponding area where they develop. In India, it is simply known as cyclones. In Australia, they are not as willy willies. So take note. Now, cyclones are fairly predictable when it comes to the place of origin. They do not originate over land. No land. And you will see the reason in a minute. They will always originate over tropical waters. They will not originate over land. Now, the second important thing is that the general motion of direction. Now, imagine, remember this, we are talking about tropical region. 30 degree here, 30 degree here, you have the equator here. What is the let me draw that again. We are talking about the tropical region, that is where the tropical cyclone originates. Okay, that's much better. What is the predominant wind system or wind pattern in this region? That is your trade winds. And the general direction of motion of tropical cyclones mirrors this trade winds. Trade winds flow from east to west. East to west. So that is the general direction of motion of tropical cyclones also. Now let's talk about the energy. Where does this massive circulating system of air gets its energy? It derives its energy from the process of condensation. For those who do not understand condensation, condensation is a process whereby you convert water vapor to its liquid form, that is a dew. When you convert, imagine this. Where do you get water vapor? What do you have to do? You have to supply heat. You have to supply heat to a molecule of water to change its states into water vapor. And this water vapor has the heat, and what happens when it is converted into liquid? It has to release that heat. It releases that heat and it is converted into liquid. That release of heat is the energy that the tropical cyclone uses for its formation and to get to its maturity. That is a source of energy. That is the reason why it always originates over tropical waters, because it needs a constant supply of this energy source. It needs a constant supply of moist water, which contains water vapor, so that through condensation, the heat energy will be released, so tropical cyclones can grow and mature. Three important facts you have to remember. Now, consider this. If these are the only things that you need for a tropical cyclone to originate and mature, that means if you need, all you need is open water and good solar radiation, that means you'll have tropical cyclones all throughout the calendar month. But that's not the case. We have specific seasonal character of tropical cyclones. In India, it is a pre-monsoon phenomena. Tropical cyclone happens before the monsoon when the heat is maximum. The reason for this is a fact that there are other factors that need to be satisfied for a tropical cyclone to originate and mature. What are these factors?